But now back on the Wild with Dumba to lead the attack. Matt Cullen into the zone, a drive, save, and the rebound pushed away by Rene, and then it gets swept out of the crease. Now reshuffle, Granlund, and he scores! The Wild kept it alive, and Mikhail Granlund snaps it in. It's 1-0 Minnesota.
Well, Pekka Rinne had a tough time corralling a rebound off an initial shot by Matt Cullen. Dumba kicks it out to Cullen. A rebound that Rinne could not control. They got away with it right there. Eventually, it ends up right back in the slot on Granlund's stick. A little bit of a screen in front of Rinne. He's not able to pick it up in time and not able to get down in time as that one sneaks right through the wickets of Pekka Rinne. But all because of the rebound control of Rinne early on in that shot. He was not able to control it, kept the play alive. The Wild make him pay.
Here's Emelin with it. Long drive, sails wide. Subban steps up to keep it in. His wrist shot turned away by Dubnyk. Score! That broke through Dubnyk. And P.K. Subban will get it as that had eyes and broke over the goal line to tie the game.
Well, we'll have to take a look to see if this hits anybody on the way in. I don't think it does. I think this just simply squeaks through the arm of Devin Dubnyk. And P.K. Subban, you see the Predator just getting pucks to the net. That's a shot towards the net, goes wide. Subban just flings his puck to the net. And I don't believe that that caught Craig Smith on the way in. And I think it just simply squeaks through the arm of Devin Dubnyk. He thinks he has it. He tries to lean back and get it. Unfortunately, it just squeaks over the goal line. But credit to the Predators. I mean, look, they haven't had the start that they wanted in this hockey game after that fight. They had a mentality of getting pucks to the net. The first one missed, the second one on net, and they get rewarded. On the net, he plays that type of game. They're missing that in their lineup right now, and the tenacity of Zach Parise. When they get those guys back, that's when we're going to have to judge these guys for real.
Granlund shot, score! Mikhail Granlund with 2 goals already. This one on the power play to give the Wild the lead again.
Well, this is some shot right here by Mikhail Granlund. Quick work here by the Minnesota Wild. It's all off the entry. A good job gaining the zone. And then a nice little feed in. Look at that shot. Short side over the blocker. Good feed here by Spurgeon to Granlund. That high blocker's open as Pekka Rinne was covering the low part of the net. And Granlund, recognizing that, was thinking quick and shot that above Pekka Rinne on the short side. A good start for Granlund and the Minnesota Wild here in this first period.
Find himself a little bit of room. Brodin across to Dumba. Shakes his way into the middle of Salamaki. Looking for a lane. Shot! Score! Nice move by Matt Dumba. And Minnesota with a 3-1 lead.
Well, this is just a fantastic play by Matt Dumba. You can see the skill level on this young defenseman. The Wild do a good job of getting this puck down low and working it up top. Matt Cullen with the puck. It's all about puck possession. They work it up top, and then look at the move here by Dumba. Just shakes out Mika Salamaki. Does not do a good enough job of keeping Dumba outside. Dumba gets himself to an area where he can get that puck to the net. There's traffic in front of Pekka Rinne, and Rinne's not able to locate that puck, and it's in the net for a 3-1 lead for the Wild. But a good job by Matt Dumba to use his skating ability to get to an area where he can get that puck in a more dangerous area.
Well, Matt Dumba had one called back earlier in the period due to goaltender interference. Here's Smith. You'll see a little backhand feed for Subban. Dozen seconds on the power play. Turris scores! Kyle Turris rips it home from the right side with 10 seconds to go on the power play, and the Predators within one.
Well, this is an absolute snipe by Kyle Turris. Good work by the Predators to stay with it. They don't score on the 5-on-3, but they don't give up. They keep working the puck on the wall, get it to the side of Turris, who's on his strong side right there. I mean, this shot is from the outside of the dot, but this is an absolute bullet over the glove-hand side of Devin Dubnyk. Typically, that would be an easy save for a goaltender on that angle as a right-hand shot, but when you put it off the bar and in, it becomes awfully difficult to save.
Fiala trying to jam it out in front, blocked by Suter. Koivu up ahead, not a stall, with Granlund towards the empty net. Granlund for the hat trick, and he scores! Mikhail Granlund, his second career hat trick. Here come the hats in St. Paul. It's 4-2 Wild.
Well, a it's only fitting that he ends up getting the empty net hat trick. He's been fantastic all night long. Like I said earlier, the puck has seemed to follow him. He had jump in his step early on in his hockey game. And he gets rewarded with an empty net goal to seal the hat trick. Right here, you see Eric Staal makes a nice little dump pass to Mikhail Granlund. And it's easy pickings at that point, but a nice little play here by Staal. He recognizes that Granlund's looking for number three. And an unselfish play by Eric Staal, and the Hats pour onto the ice here in Minnesota.